Hello everyone, Adam Muhammad Setuoka Bilago, and today's video, I want to share with you guys how to swap Kringles for BNB or USDT BEP20. Now, let me say this, okay? USDT BEP20 simply means USDT on Binance Smart Chain. So, which means that the only wallet that you can send the USDT BEP20 okay, to is a Trust wallet or a Binance wallet. Please do not send USDT BEP20 to an Ethereum address of USDT. I know the addresses might be similar, but at the same time, okay, there are two different blockchains, despite the fact that they use the same address. Because if you send it to a wallet that does not recognize BEP20, your USDT is gone. Okay? So take note of this before I start. Now, in the steps of converting Kringle to Binance Coin or USDT BEP20, you have to go through GCT and you have to go through converting GCT to any of these four tokens: Little Rabbit, SafeMoon Cash, Fake Token, and Spore Token. These are the four cryptocurrencies that is currently paired to GCT. Okay, so it's not like you will swap Kringles immediately for BNB, or you will swap Kringles immediately for USDT BEP20. No, you have to go through a process. The first process requires you to pay your $10 admin fee, $10 fee, GCT fee, for that covers a month. For that period of month, you have to convert Kringle to GCT. You do that by sending Kringle to me, and I send GCT to you. Okay? And 1 billion Kringle is equals to 1 GCT. Now, that is step number one, after paying the admin fee and converting Kringle to GCT. Step number two is converting GCT to either SafeMoon Cash, Fake Token, Spore Token, or Little Rabbit Token. I've done 4 videos on this. They are all available on my YouTube channel. So if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, subscribe now, turn on the notification bell, and go and check out all my previous videos. At the same time, if you are in the GCT community group, which is Global Community Token Group, okay, if you are there, you can go and check it out, because those videos are there in the group. Okay, now once you've gotten these 4 tokens, whether it's Spore Token, whether it's Little Rabbit, whether it's SafeMoon Cash, or whether it's Fake Token, one thing they all have in common is that they are paired to BNB. And as long as they are paired to BNB on PancakeSwap, not FoodmanSwap, PancakeSwap, okay, what will happen is that you can swap those coins for BNB, or you can go for USDT BEP20. So how do you now swap Little Rabbit Token, or Fake Token, or SafeMoon Cash, or Spore Token for PancakeSwap? So what you do is you come in the dApp session of your Trust wallet, okay, in the dApp session, and click on PancakeSwap. All right, so once you click on PancakeSwap, pancakefinance.finance/swap, you click connect. Now, when the connection is done, you will notice that if you have BNB, it will reflect in the balance, meaning that you've connected your wallet to PancakeSwap. Okay, now because I want BNB, okay, what I'll do is click this arrow in the middle to send BNB down. Then I select Spore Token. I don't know if I have Spore Token here. Okay, you either select Spore. If you've not added Spore before, use the contract address of Spore to add it to your PancakeSwap, okay? Whether it's Spore or FEG, okay? Okay? Or Fake Token or SafeMoon Cash, if it's SafeMoon Cash that you have. Sorry, this is SafeMoon. All right, SafeMoon Cash, they're different. All right, SafeMoon Cash. Okay, I don't have SafeMoon Cash, so I'll get the contract address and paste it. All right, what else again? Little Rabbit. Okay, Little Rabbit token. So if you don't have the contract address of these tokens, what you simply need to do is either come to the GCT community group and ask for the contract address of SafeMoon Cash and Little Rabbit, or you can go to BSC Scan and search for it. Okay, so but I won't show that in this video. There's already a video for that. Okay, you can okay. So when you ask me about how to get contract address, I can forward that to you. Okay, so let me get the SafeMoon Cash and Little Rabbit contract token. All right, so I've gotten the contract address for Little Rabbit token, so I'm going to paste it here. Okay, it's going to ask me to import, so I click import, I understand, and import. So at this point now, whatever Little Rabbit token I have, I can click max, and it shows me the number of BNB that I have. Now let's say I don't want Little Rabbit token, that I want USDT. I just come here and type USDT. USDT comes out. Okay, and I type in the amount of Little Rabbit that I have, or I click max if I want to swap all, and it tells me how many USDT I will receive. Okay, now when you have this USDT, okay, you can easily send it to your Binance wallet, or you contact a crypto dealer and ask him if he buys USDT BEP20. Okay, and ask him if he buys USDT BEP20. Okay, or if you convert to BNB, you contact your crypto dealer and ask if he buys BNB, Smart Chain BNB. Same thing applies to what's it called, when you want to swap SafeMoon, when you want to swap SafeMoon Cash. Okay, SafeMoon Cash. All right, so same thing is that you swap SafeMoon Cash to USDT or BNB, then you take it instead of sending it to Binance Exchange. Binance Exchange is a situation, if for you to send to Binance Exchange is only if you don't have a peer-to-peer system person or crypto dealer that you trust. If you don't have that and you want the person, you want a situation whereby you trust Binance to do everything through Binance, then you move it to your Binance account. As long as I'm concerned, if you have a P2P person, okay, like I'm a crypto dealer myself, so if you contact me and say you want to sell BNB or USDB B20, I'll buy it outright from you. Okay, so same thing goes for if you want to swap a Spore token. All right, Spore token. Okay, you said that you swap to USDT or you swap to BNB. Okay. Now, you might decide to say that you want to swap to Bitcoin, okay? Whether it's possible to swap to Bitcoin or Ethereum. Is it possible to swap to Bitcoin or Ethereum? But this Bitcoin and Ethereum are BEP20 Bitcoin and Ethereum. So, which means they are running on Binance Smart Chain. So, which means that if you want to sell it to me or sell it to a dealer, you have to specify that this is the Bitcoin that you have, or this is the Ethereum that you have. Okay, because if you mistakenly send Bitcoin BEP20 to a normal Segwit Bitcoin address, it's gone. Okay, it's gone. If you try to send Ethereum BEP20 to an Ethereum ERC20 wallet, okay, that has no other option for BEP20, it is gone. So if you want to swap Spore token, Little Rabbit, SafeMoon Cash, fake token to BTC BEP20, then you come here and type BTC. You can see it here. This is BTCB. This is same value as your Bitcoin, for those who are asking if they can get Bitcoin. Okay, same value as a Bitcoin, but the only issue is it is on Binance Smart Chain. So which means, okay, that you have to send it to your Binance, where you can easily exchange it to cash. Okay, you can easily send it to cash through the withdrawal, through the, you know, the cash out system of Binance. Okay, but if you want to go through a middleman, a crypto dealer, okay, you have to specify that this is Bitcoin BEP20. Same thing with Ethereum. Okay, this is Ethereum on Binance Smart Chain. Same value, same logo, but different contract address and different networks. So, which means that you have to be careful, you have to know what you are doing. I know if I do this video, most people will not watch it to the end and people still come to complain. Please make sure if you're watching this video, you watch it two times, three times to understand it. Anything you don't understand, ask your question in the group. Okay? Ask your question in the group. So you can always swap, or what's it called? Fake token. Okay? You can always swap fake token to Ether, BTCB, BNB, or USDT. Okay? So all these four tokens can be converted to BNB, USDT, BTC BEP20, Ethereum BEP20. Okay? So make sure you have at least $2, $5 smart chain in your balance while doing this, because this coin you are interacting with, these four coins, which is Fake Token, Spot Token, Little Rabbit, and SafeMoon Cash, have one thing in common. They are deflationary tokens, so there's always a percentage of the transaction fee that always goes to the holders of the token. Okay? As such, the transaction fees might not be normal compared to other cryptocurrencies. Okay? So guys, that's it for this video. Okay? That's for this video. Just want to share this with you guys. All right? So I'll see you guys next time. If you have your questions, ask in the comment section or directly to me, to the global community group. And I'll see you guys next time. Take care and bye for now.